coming up next on ATETV. Information and communication technologies.
There's a number of different paths you can take. We have the customer engineer role, and then you have an implementation engineer. You could be a lab engineer working on a specific product.
And precision agriculture.
A large benefit of moving into the agriculture technology field would be job security. There's a lot of cooperatives, a lot of farmers that are needing a guy to work for the farming operation. And basically, all they do is the technology stuff.
Now on ATETV. From across the country to your own backyard, ATETV shows you the many advanced technological education opportunities available at your local community college. Thinking of plugging into a career working with computers? Information and communication technology programs offered at community colleges can help you boot up your future. Take a look.
Here's your router. It'll go to the firewall.
What you hear is that there's no jobs available for people with yesterday's skills who were taught with yesterday's techniques. But there are plenty of jobs available for people with tomorrow's skills who were taught with advanced instructional techniques.
So we connect everything to the hub and then something off the router?
I think students are naturally drawn to careers in IT and ICT. They're immersed in it, telecommunications, networking, security, wireless. They live, eat, and breathe this stuff, and they assume that they know everything about it just because they do it every day. But then once you get them in a class, they really start to see the mechanics behind how all of this stuff is happening. And I think one of the reasons why the community college is such a great avenue for that is you know, we are, you know, the hands-on teachers.
So if I do virtual clone,
we all really try to promote the hands-on aspects. So if after 2 years you need a job, you can pretty much hit the ground running.
There's a lot of different career options and a lot of different career opportunities for people with this kind of background.
The kinds of skills that you need vary widely, but I think a tremendous interest in technology and a passion for being able to solve technology-based problems are the two principal ingredients for success.
There's a number of different paths you can take it. We have the customer engineer role. They do the break fix type activities, replace the parts, work on all the different systems. And then you have an implementation engineer. Sort of works closer with the customer in that they do a lot of configuration type things. You have to know the customer environment a little bit. You could be a lab engineer, work on a specific product. And we do that on a daily basis. We have a day and a night shift.
Somebody's looking at a career with a traditional telecommunications company like a Verizon or an AT&T. With a 2-year degree, you can get a job in a company like that and you can establish a career track. Another way students can go is they can start their own businesses. There's a lot of technician work now with this home technology integration area. We also have students going to work for places like hospitals.
The work that I do right now at the hospital, I actually am a first-level technician. And there are some higher-level network engineers that actually do this kind of job. And that's something that I might be looking forward to doing in the future, you know. That's why I've come to the school.
The huge potential and huge opportunity there is the IT and communications infrastructure for our health system is updated to modern, to modern technology.
I think it's important for students to go in IT. There always is a need for talented people in the industry and for people that want to excel and that have had an information technology background or a love for computers. It's a great career path.
If you're looking for a challenging and secure field to work in, information and communication technologies might be right for you. Be sure to check out your local community college to see what programs they offer. Interested in helping farmers work more productively and efficiently? Love hands-on technology in both an indoor and outdoor working environment? Then maybe you should look into a career in precision agriculture.
My name is Dan Bossman. I am a technology manager for Premier Grain based out of Troy Mills, Iowa. And I run all the data collection, data processing from all the equipment, and then all the computer stuff in the office. I went to Kirkwood in 2000 for the GPS GIS program. I'm just gonna wait for it to warm up and find some satellites. It gave me a great deal of knowledge as to how the satellites work, how the computers take that data and turn it into data that we can use. A large benefit of moving into the agriculture technology field would be job security. There's a lot of cooperatives, a lot of farmers that are needing a guy to work for the farming operation. And basically all they do is the technology stuff. And as technology progresses, there's gonna be a larger need for guys with those skills. You could find a job such as mine working for a farming operation. You could find a job working for a cooperative, chemical companies, seed dealers, working for seed companies. Anybody who uses or is involved in agriculture and uses technology, there should be an opening somewhere for that position. As farming operations get larger and it becomes more expensive to farm that acre of ground, and more guys move toward the technology side of things to help offset those costs a little bit, there'll be a large opportunity for guys with technology skills or degrees in technology that can help those guys get to where they want to be.
Today's technology is revitalizing agriculture and providing us with exciting opportunities, such as field mapping and soil sampling using GPS. And precision agriculture is a secure and rapidly growing technical field. For more information on anything you've seen today, explore our website at atetv.org. Thanks for watching.